Hey everybody. Today we're going to have a look at my native tank while I throw some food in there and get a little bit of activity going. But what we're going to talk about is a follow-up to a video I shot the other day. I shot a video discussing the idea that some people will claim that sometimes fish just die for no reason. And I got a little bit of feedback on it that I wanted to address. A few people did say that often when people say that, they probably mean the fish died of old age. That's not what I'm talking about. The fish dying of old age is a cause. The old age is what the fish is dying from. And like anything else, whether it's a person or a dog or a tree, when something dies from old age, you can tell it's aging and it's getting more and more decrepit and it slowly deteriorates and breaks down and eventually succumbs to age. I'm discussing fish that suddenly die. They look good and healthy one minute and you come in that afternoon and it's dead on the bottom or it's swimming upside down and then it's gone an hour later. Under those circumstances, there's still a reason the fish died. There's still a cause of death. I spoke a little bit about water hardness, and some people seem to suggest that I was saying that whenever you can't explain the fish's death, it's because of water hardness. I wasn't saying that either. I'm simply throwing that out there as a possible reason that is difficult to identify and leaves no visible marks. It's simply your fish look fine one minute, and eventually their kidneys give out, and once their kidneys give out, they very quickly go from looking perfectly normal to being dead. And that can happen. That is something that happens on a fairly regular basis, particularly after a large water change. You can shift the pH, you can shift the water's hardness. There's a lot of reasons that fish can die. And that was my point, is that fish just die is not a reason. Fish don't simply decide to stop living and die. There's a cause of death. Just because we don't know what that cause is doesn't mean there was no cause. There's still a cause of death. So what this video is going to be about is the particular cause of death that a lot of people seem to want to attribute, and that is heart attacks in fish. And this is a topic that's fascinated me for a while. I don't hear it a lot, but I do hear people from time to time saying fish have heart attacks during water changes because of the stress of the water change or what have you. And this is simply not true. I am not saying, I want to say this right now because I'm sure there's already people rushing to the comment section to explain to me that if a fish has a heart, it can have a heart attack. I'm not saying that fish cannot have heart attacks. I'm just saying that they generally don't. And I'm going to explain why, and we're going to have a very nice discussion about heart attacks today while I feed the fish. So I'm going to go over there and put a lot of flakes in and get them swirled around. That'll get them started, and then I'll put some algae wafers in at the other end for the bottom feeders, and then that'll just give us something to look at while we talk about hearts and heart attacks. So first of all, when people say fish just die of heart attacks, they probably really mean cardiac arrest as opposed to heart attack. There's a big difference, and cardiac arrest is when your heart simply stops working suddenly. A heart attack is something a little different than that. So first of all, the way hearts work is you've got a basic muscle chamber, and in the case of higher order animals like us, we have four chambers in our hearts, and they beat rhythmically so that one after the other pushes the blood through valves and it goes through the heart, and the heart acts as a pump that circulates our blood through our body. Reptiles and amphibians have three-chambered hearts, and fish have the most simplistic of true hearts, and that is a two-chambered heart with one simple valve in between them. Any animals lower order than fish, such as inverts, don't have true hearts in the sense of having chambers and valves, so we're not going to get into discussing that. That's a little different altogether. So a fish does have a heart that is similar to ours, but it's just very, very much more simplistic. Two simple chambers with one valve in between. So, in our hearts, what is a heart attack and how do we have them? A heart attack is when blood flow is cut off to part of some of that muscle tissue. Remember, your heart is just a big muscle. So, when some of that blood gets cut off to that muscle, that muscle begins suffering. It's not getting oxygen, it's not having waste taken away from it, and if this goes on long enough, a few hours, that muscle tissue will die. So the heart attack is simply when the muscle tissue is not getting enough blood, and it's starving for oxygen, and you're getting the pain and the sweats, and you feel like you got the indigestion, and that's a heart attack. Cardiac arrest is when your heart stops beating, and that's generally caused by things like electrocution, drowning, suffocation. You can have atrial defibrillation, where your heart's actually not beating properly, so the blood doesn't move through it, and it's effectively not beating. So when it finally gets oxygen starved, it just stops. So the causes of cardiac arrest are slightly different. Strangely enough, the number one cause of cardiac arrest is heart attacks. If you have a very large heart attack, a large portion of muscle is not getting blood. When that portion of muscle dies, sometimes it just isn't enough to keep your heart beating anymore, and then you go into cardiac arrest where your heart actually stops beating. So the heart attack part of it is what I want to discuss, because the idea that a fish or even a person, you know, we see it in the movies or whatever, it's sort of a running joke. They were so frightened, they'd clutch their chest and fall over dead. People don't simply have cardiac arrest because they're frightened or overly stressed, unless they've got other issues going on. So what really goes on in our hearts and why we have heart attacks as we age, it's partially because of aging. It's called arterial sclerosis, and that's just a hardening of the arteries as we age. This is just something that happens. And because of our diet and cholesterol and triglycerides and fats, we get what is known as plaque that builds up inside of our arteries. So a couple of things can happen. Either the plaque can build to the point where, you know, think about the inside of a pipe getting more and more clogged, less and less fluid can flow through it, and eventually you get limited blood flow to areas of your hearts. Now that's still not necessarily going to cause a heart attack, but that's a situation where sitting around watching TV is going to be fine, but if you go out and shovel snow, you get terrible chest pains. That's called angina. And that is similar to a heart attack in that you're experiencing the pain because not enough blood is getting to the muscle tissue. Some blood is still flowing there. You're not at a heart attack yet. You're still getting blood. It's just not enough. It's like when your legs start burning when you've been running. You gotta slow down and take it easy because you're not getting enough oxygen to the muscles for the muscles being used. And that's what angina is. So the idea that your heart was pounding because you were terrified, again, angina might play into that or something, but it's suddenly just seizing up out of terror, which is what I'm assuming people are getting at when they talk about a fish dying of a heart attack during the terrifying water change. I'm not really sure why people would think a fish would have a heart attack during a water change, other than it just was so stressful that their hearts just seize up and they just die of a heart attack. That's not something that really genuinely happens in the real world. And that's even with our hearts, as complicated as they are, and with our terrible diet, and many, many long years that we live, and all the time it takes for all this cholesterol and triglycerides and stuff to build up this plaque that's in our arteries. Fish don't have any of that. They don't get the triglycerides. They don't have high cholesterol diets. They don't live for very long periods of time where they're suffering from plaque buildup and heart disease. Those are all people things. So heart problems in fish just aren't really that common, unless it's a genetic or, you know, congenital defect or something like that. That would be different. Again, I've already said it's not impossible for fish to have heart attacks. But what about a water change would cause a heart attack or a cardiac arrest? Presumably that's what we're talking about. Fish suddenly die, their hearts stop beating out of the sheer terror of the water change. Again, I'm assuming that's where we're going with that. What is it about a water change that would do that? Why would they suddenly have a heart attack? It makes no sense. There's no logic behind it. The other reason that we will have heart attacks is that plaque can sort of crack or rupture, or if enough of it is causing a little bit of a disturbance in the flow of blood, your blood's natural clotting agents, the platelets, will start to collect on it and grab it, and it will begin to build a blood clot in your artery. And it can either get big enough that it begins blocking the blood flow and you start experiencing the angina, or it breaks loose, and as it flows down the pipe, it gets to a fork where there's two smaller pipes. It either blocks one or both or partially, and now you're having heart attack issues because suddenly the blood flow has been stopped to part of the muscle that makes up your heart. Again, the fish don't have these issues. It's just not something that's really going to be going on in fish. They have a very, very simple circulatory system. The two-chambered heart, it goes from their heart directly to their gills, just in the same way with us, it goes directly to our lungs to exchange all the gases, pick up all the fresh oxygen. And in our case, the blood flows directly back to our heart because our heart needs the most oxygen. Fish don't do that. Fish go through their heart, into the gills, and then the blood goes throughout the body and back around and makes the whole entire circuit and then comes back through the heart again to go through the whole cycle again. So without there being a high cholesterol diet and your fish being all overweight and out of shape and suffering from heart disease, chances are pretty unlikely that they're going to have a heart attack. And as far as having a cardiac arrest, a simple seizing up of their heart out of the sheer terror, again, I don't understand how that's supposed to work. What mechanism causes their heart to suddenly stop beating? The rapidity of it, you know, if it's beating so fast it just blows itself out, it just doesn't work that way. And depending on the species of fish, their heartbeat could be anywhere from 70 to 250 beats a minute. So they're fish don't have hearts like us. They don't have heart attacks the way we do. And doing a water change isn't going to be a cause of a heart attack. So that's the long and short of it. That was what I wanted to cover mostly in this video, was the idea of heart attacks and fish. So if you think I failed to cover something properly, or you do think there is a reason or a way that fish can have heart attacks, I would love to hear the explanation. Again, saying fish do have heart attacks, you know, okay, if you want to say that, you can say that. I'm not going to disagree with you, but that's not the point I'm making, and I'm not making the argument that it's impossible for a fish to have a heart attack. I'm just saying that if you've got a dead fish on the other side of a water change, it isn't because it had a heart attack. If you think it is because it had a heart attack, I would love to know why you think it was a heart attack, rather than just taking it on faith that you believe it to be a heart attack. What would cause the fish to have a heart attack under those circumstances? So, probably the only video you're going to ever see where someone talks at length about fish having heart attacks during water change, but there you go, that's what you get with my channel. You never know what you're going to get with me, so make sure you're subscribed, because it's always something good and you don't want to miss any of it. Thanks again for watching this. Don't forget, this is my native tank. I have plenty others down here, and you don't want to miss any of them either. So thanks again, and I will see you real soon on the next one.